सीजन एडवोकेट शेखर खापड़े जी, डॉक्टर संजीव शांत कुमार जी, ऑल द रिस्पेक्टेबल टीचिंग स्टाफ एंड माय डियर फ्रेंड्स, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई कॉन्ग्रेचुलेट दिस इंस्टीट्यूशन फॉर कंडक्टिंग सच अ सेमिनार कवरिंग वेरियस एस्पेक्ट्स ऑफ लाइफ विच इम्पैक्ट्स डे टू डे लाइफ. And it is very important for students to know what is going on, what are the happenings in this country, and how we as a student should take up the challenges, be prepared, and lead this nation. Nabha Pariksha was rightly saying that future is out of the students sitting across me, and therefore all such topics are very important. The topic on which I am supposed to talk is on human rights. Much has been talked about human rights violation in this country. I can see in this hall also. Students are forced to sit for 2 days in this hall. Are you sitting happily?
Yes, sir.
Anybody against? He can raise his hand. Okay. You are asked to wear uniforms. You are asked to sit in class. You are asked to do homework. Is not this human violation? Tell me very honestly. It's a violation. So friends, let us come to a serious subject. United Nations is very strongly dealing with this concept of human rights. Around 192 nations are members of this whole journey, and they meet every 4 years to discuss, evaluate what is happening in each of the countries. What does it mean, human rights? Human rights means rights which should be made available for a human being to be a human being. So where natural justice, natural equity, natural expectations are there, all are supposed to be protected, safeguarded, is the concept. And while doing that, one should not think of what gender he is of, what caste, what religion, what language. So for human rights protection, all such things should not be looked into. All should be treated at par. So now this is the theory of human nation, basically, United Nations. But how to implement country-wise? I think before United Nations organization told us anything, our great writers of Constitution of India, Dr. Babasaheb Ambedkar and his team, they have already mentioned in Article 12 to Article 35 what are the fundamental rights, what are the rights for the protection of human being. And therefore, whose rights are to be protected generally should not be questioned. Each and everything is dealt with, and it is obligatory on the part of any government to facilitate the lives of the human being so that they are not at any disadvantageous stage. But it is true, till today, after almost 70 years of independence, all human beings of this country are not at par. And therefore, the constitutionally, by trying to give hand-holding for those who are downtrodden, who needs helping hand, and therefore through resolution or through some special scheme, by trying to upgrade them. So that is the reality. There is yet no equality amongst all in terms of human being. But I disagree that there is gender neutrality issue, caste neutrality issue, religion neutrality issue And even if there is any violation, our laws, our courts, our system are capable of handling it. But still, why we hear a lot of noise about violation? When I ask your friends, the first question to you, are you also victim of human violation? You said yes, maybe out of lighter tone. But exactly, at national level also, there is a misconception about human violation. See, when the Constitution of India allows you to do certain things in certain way, then one should not question that there is a violation. Supposing there is a big dam to be built here in Nagpur, naturally the government will have to acquire land, and acquisition of land can always be done through due process of law, and there has to be displacement of people happening there. And by displacing, there is a set down guideline that how the compensation has to be given to them, how to protect their interest. But still, though I am a politician, I am a spokesperson for a political party, but still there are various activists, just to show their presence, just to create their leadership through this kind of thing, they do a lot of tautomy about violations. But in reality, that is not a violation. Development has to be there. We all are in favor of that. Like our Honorable CA wants a Samruddhi Mahamarga starting from Nagpur, ending at Mumbai. We all need that. Because for transport system at lesser cost, lesser time, is a welcome for all business community, for commuter also. And therefore, we need to acquire lands. And while doing that, there would be lots of issues. I am not denying that there will be denied issues, voices also. But there is a process, due process of law to settle those issues. But unnecessarily making UN crowd out of that is not really advisable. But this government at the center, I will just give two, three examples what they are doing. And I think that is a mark towards human rights. When our Honorable Prime Minister says Sabka Saath Sabka Vikas, and when he talks about electricity, then Masjidin doesn't look into that, whether he is a male, female, caste, religion. Any house which is unelectrified has to be given electricity. Like post-independence, there were 18,000 villages where there was no electricity reach yet. I'll give one example of Elephantachu, which is very at short distance from Mumbai. There was no electricity after 70 years also. But this government provided electricity by putting cable from the sea and provided electricity. When we talk about roads, lots of development is happening. Irrigation, there is opening of bank accounts, giving all the benefits directly to their accounts. This is all about Sabka Saath Sabka Vikas or human rights protection. And our constitution provides for all those things. I think when we expect something from leaders, leaders are supposed to work well within the constitution of India, which is what this government is doing. Now there are some exceptions, yes, I do not want to politicize this, but my previous speaker, I heard him about violations and all that thing. Unless it is proved, you cannot say it's a violation. Like in 1984, there was a riots. There was genocide of Sikhs. Now Supreme Court after 35 years, they have convicted. So it's a violation. There are lots of deaths occurring in Kerala. RSS people are being killed. That is violation, yes. But in larger way, you have to look at it. When this government, Mr. Modi, has come, You have not heard about any kind of riot, any kind of discriminatory. All the schemes and policies are meant for a people who is standing in last at the queue. We call it as Antyodaya. Gandhiji also spoke out Antyodaya. Dindyal Upadhyayji also spoke out Antyodaya. So person who is deprived of all the facilities should get such facilities, be it education, be it water resource, be it bank facilities, be it financial benefits, everything. I think we should not be unduly worried about this concept of human rights, violation or other things. I think our judiciary, our government, be of whatever party, they have got all the rights to protect the interest of the human beings. There is no question of somebody else taking law in their hand and leading that movement and showing that we are the real messiah for the human rights. This United Nations is also very active on this. They are also, from time to time, they are evaluating it. In terms of human rights, our index in India is going up and up. Things are moving. Let us not be negative. Think of positive. I think our country is progressing well. In terms of international image also, we are progressing. And with this, I think I have a limited time. I'll stop here. Thank you very much for hearing me.